Up next, Leon Russell explains just why Englishman Joe Cocker needed for him to put together an all-American band in less than 3 weeks. I'm Redbeard in the studio for the 35th anniversary of Joe Cocker's Mad Dogs and Englishmen.
Hi, this is Joe Cocker in the studio for the 35th anniversary of Mad Dogs and Englishmen.
I'm Redbeard. Joe Cocker had his Grease band from England to tour the U.S. with him a year earlier, including Woodstock. But this time, only keyboard player Chris Stainton was available. Leon Russell explains it.
For one reason or other, Joe had fired his band in England. He had 50 shows booked in the United States. And he was going to cancel them because he didn't feel like doing it for some reason. And the musicians' union told him they wouldn't let him play in the United States again if he didn't play those shows. So suddenly he was over here without a band, and he had to do the shows on very short notice. And so he asked me to put the band together for him. My theory was that it could be recorded and filmed, and use the actual income of the tour to make the movie, which would be a larger event actually than the tour, which is pretty much what happened. Partially it was based on the Woodstock film, but I mean, it's obvious that films have a far-reaching effect for longer periods of time than a single concert or even a series of concerts. What happened in this case, Joe asked me my thoughts on it, and I ran it down in about 10 minutes, what could be done, what type of film crews. I requested news crews because it was documentary and it needed to be shot all the time, and it really needed to have some guys that were ready to shoot whatever came up. About a day or perhaps two later, there was two news crews standing there, and a plane was chartered. And it was all set up. Somebody did all that stuff that I said. And when we went down to start the rehearsals at the soundstage at A&M, we were making sort of potato salad in huge garbage cans because we didn't know really how many people were going to be there. It lasted about 4 days, perhaps five. And each day it sort of grew exponentially. When we first went down there, it was just all the people that I invited. The second day it was twice that many, and probably twice that many again each day following. The last day we got there, there was 400 people there probably.
Satisfied, oh Lord, yeah. The warm and tender Rock and roll. Rock and roll.
Joe Cocker singing Leon Russell's Delta Lady, which everybody believes was inspired by backing singer Rita Coolidge, who was right there on the Mad Dogs and Englishmen tour.
Leon Russell, Chris Stanton.
In the tour film, now out on DVD, it's amusing to watch Cocker's expression go from surprise to annoyed as Leon Russell continues to milk the crowd by repeating that refrain.
Most of the songs like Cry Me a River and The Letter were great. Leon, you know, came up with those brilliant arrangements. And we did some songs from Matthew Moore, Space Captain.
Right.
And his brother Daniel, you know. Someone was asking me, Beard, about the what happened to the film, because I don't think it's out on DVD.
I would love to be able to own a copy of the film.
Yeah.
I wonder who has the rights to that.
Well, it was MGM originally, and I think A&M bought back, you know, the rights to it, but I thought it would be worth putting out, you know, a limited edition or whatever.
Those of us who remember the film,